Hello and welcome. Today we have Shekhar Chibolu with us. Shekhar, first of all, congratulations for clearing your UGC NET exam. It's such an achievement. As far as I know, you cleared it in June 2020. It's still such a recent news. How do you feel about your achievement?
Yeah, I was very happy seeing that I cleared it because. As per the rules, we know that I think some 5-6% only clear the exam.
Yes.
So I felt quite happy seeing that I cleared it. First of all, I was worried that, when will I write the exam?
Yeah.
And, if I lose one more year, if I don't write it. Mm-hmm. And, of course, during this time, that date would be set and then it would get delayed. So that was all worrisome. But I think the main motivation was, hey, if I don't write it now, then what about when will it be held again, and what will be my state at that time? So I think as the date was coming close by, I was like, okay, let's get it done this time. And of course, being at the home, working from home, it gave me a little bit more time to prepare. So I think I thought, let's take advantage of it.
Well, Shekhar, we would like to know a little bit more about you. Where are you from, about your education status, and a little bit about your future aspirations.
Me? Yeah, I'm from South. I work in Hyderabad. And I've done a master's. And I would like to, do a PhD. I want to, do some academic work. And I want to kind of delve into some topics of my interest, and that's the reason for doing this NET and the PhD. And I hope to spend some time, trying to study what subject of my interest rather than somebody telling me, in school or college, study this, study that. So I'm looking forward to doing something, study of me.
Shekhar, I would like to ask you one question. What tips and tricks did you follow while preparing for such a competitive exam? That can be of help to the future aspirants too.
I think there are two parts to this. One, of course, the subject, which is management. I think I found the course material of this human parameters very good. In fact, there were some of the things I had not answered in the exam, but I knew they were in the course materials. I think, if somebody goes through that course material, I don't think there's any doubt that you'll pass the exam. Literally, when I was seeing the questions, I was remembering that, hey, this is covered there. Of course, some sections I had not read, and Indian logic and all that, but I knew they were there, the material, and I felt bad and would have kicked myself if I had not cleared. But I think the material was very good, very well printed, and error-free. So I think, definitely follow that. And I think for the first paper, of course, again, Human Parameters has got material for all the logical reasoning and all that. Very useful. I think if you do that, I think you will do very well in the exam. And I think for the English part, I think that's where you may have to keep reading newspapers and magazines. I think the questions were quite easy if you are very familiar with reading. So I would advise people to read a lot to prepare for that. But I think other than that, I think maybe website said that and that's why I bought the material. I think if you go through the material, definitely, I think you'll clear the exam.
Sure. Shekhar, there's this one more thing, the last question that I would like to ask you, that while preparing for such a competitive exam, there's a chance that people get distracted while preparing for it. Distracted in the sense that sometimes they want to have everything and everything. It's more like, taking a hand over each and every information that is available to you. And in that process, sometimes the student gets distracted. It is one of the very common mistakes that students while preparing for an exam commit. Is there anything that you would like to tell and inform these students to avoid while preparing for such an exam?
I don't know about what to avoid, but I can tell you that I think, choose one or two topics which, all exams tell. For example, I would say make sure you read economics very well, because definitely some questions will come from economics, and I think some questions will come from HR. So I think, pick a few topics which you are comfortable with, and there's a high probability of questions coming in. And I would say that, use this material to go through that. And I think this logical reasoning also, a lot of questions come from that. And, I think you could you know, unless you want to be, you know, that you want to get the JRF, but then of course you need to know everything. But if you want to clear, I think you can pick and choose and don't get overwhelmed by the whole material. If you want to do that, you could do that. But I think, you know, the material is good. Just I think spend even a couple of hours a day, you'll clear it. And being objective without negative marking, you don't have to mug it. As long as you're familiar, you go there, you remember, I think it'll be good. So I think read through it 2-3 times. You know, you'll clear it. It's objective, no negative marking. You'll be confident, I think you can.
Well, thank you so much, Shekhar, for sharing your experience with us. Again, congratulations for clearing your UGC NET exam in the management course. We wish you all the very best for all your future endeavors. And again, thank you so much for joining me and sharing your experience. Thank you so much, Shekhar.